Hi, within this tutorial we're going to determine how to inscribe several polygons inside a given circle. Okay, so today I'm going to start off and I'm just going to mark out three circles at equal intervals, okay, just of the same size, just to keep it simple for laying out on the sheet. Okay, I have my XY line here. I came up a height of 50 millimeters, which is going to be the center point of these circles, and I'm going to space them out here and draw vertical lines down through them to locate each circle. Okay, so first of all, I'm just going to start out with the first circle here at a radius of 50 millimeters. I'm going to draw this circle using that as a center point. Set the radius, you put your compass on the center point, set the radius down to the XY line which I already have drawn in, and rotate that circle. Okay, now that I have my circle in place, the first one I'm going to inscribe an equilateral triangle within the circle. So an equilateral triangle, we know, is a triangle with three equal sides and length and with three equal internal angles. Alright, so I'm going to start off with the top of my triangle at this top point of the circle, and I'm going to label that point A. So the next thing I got to do is determine the angle from point A down towards the edge of the circle, and we know the angle of an equilateral triangle is 60 degrees. I'm going to get my 60 degree set square here, and I'm going to draw that line until it intersects the edge of the circle to give me a second point. Another way I can do that, well, I can also drop that down from the point A at the same angle. Just turn your set square around, drop it down on the other side, which will give you a second point, and then draw your horizontal line across, and those two lines should be hitting the circle at the same height. Okay, so now you have point A, B, and C. Okay, so as I always like to do, draw in our light lines first as construction lines, and then we'll go back over them with heavy pencil when we know everything is correct. There you go. So this is basically your equilateral triangle inscribed within the circle. So the next one I'm going to do is to inscribe a hexagon within a circle of the same radius. We'll keep it at 100 millimeters diameter, 50 mm radius. Just for this exercise, to keep it less complicated. Okay, so the first thing I'm going to do is draw that circle, and we're asked to inscribe a hexagon within that circle. Okay, so going back to the principle of the hexagon again, we know a hexagon has six sides. So in order to determine the measurement of the angle we're dealing with a hexagon, we divide 360 degrees by six, and that gives us a 60 degree angle between both vertices. So what I mean by that, if I was, for example, to extend both sides of the hexagon on and measure the angle between them, we would be left with 60 degrees. Okay, so the most convenient way for this, I think, is if you're given a point on your circle, I'm going to start with this point up here on top, and again, I'm going to call that point A. Okay, so I know if I have the line from point A coming out of this direction and coming in the opposite direction, the angle between those must be 60 degrees. So if the angle between those is 60 degrees, I'm going to draw a line out on one side at 30 degrees. Okay. And I'm also going to draw it in the opposite direction at 30 degrees. Okay. That then should leave you with an angle at those vertices if you check that angle the angle should add up to 30 and 30, which makes 60 degrees, which is perfect in this situation, okay? Another way I could do that is come off at those points as well, measuring my angles. What I'm going to do in this situation, just to make it a bit easier to understand, we know that each side on the hexagon is supposed to be and should be the exact same length. So using one of those lines, I'm going to set my compass to where it intersects the circle. I'm going to move my compass to the end point of that line, inscribe an arc. Again, where that crosses the circle, I'm going to set my compass and so on till I get right around to the other side. Okay, and this last point should end up in line with the previous line that I've drawn. As you can see, it is perfectly matching up here. So it's vital that we make everything as precise as we can and to ensure that we get the perfect solution at the end of the question. You can see now we have our little arcs across the circle in several points here. So I'm just going to label them, following it on from A, B, C, D, E, and F, and we're going back to A again. So as always, I'm going to draw those lines in light first of all. So this would be done with your light pencil, following those lines through to make sure that everything is lining up correctly. And as you can see, when you draw the final line in, that everything is meeting that perfectly. So now we know that we can go over that with a heavy pencil in your case. Okay, so I'm just going to go back over all those lines, draw them in heavy just to make that stand out. And that is the hexagon inscribed within the circle as asked in the question. Go, so we point A, B, C, D, E, and F, and this is your hexagon inscribed within the given circle.